There are two problems, known by all. What I just said, external, Putin and Russian aggression, and an internal one, corruption. There are others too, but these are the main ones. I knew of them when I was still there, but it was not until I returned here, after 1.5 months, at home, in Ukraine, among Ukrainians, that I saw the third problem. It's us. I got back from Poland recently, where I had multiple meetings. There was a big meeting, and one guy took the microphone and asked. He posed a very frank question. Oleg, you returned home after 5 years. Did you see the same relations between people that were present on the Maidan? And I said, no, I don't see this. I remember very well what it was like back then, that winter, when we spoke to each other, politely, civilly, openly, honestly. I remember the light and the warmth between the people. It helped me all those 5 years. I knew what I was risking everything in Crimea for. I knew what I was serving my term for. I knew what I was doing it for. It helped me. Having returned and seen what is happening in our society, I realized, to my great disappointment, that we have lost it all. The revolution of dignity has turned into the counter-revolution of hatred, as bitter as it sounds. We are very aggressive towards each other. We are very divided. We are intolerant of any opinion, and not the opinion of our enemies in Mordor, but the opinion of our neighbors and close ones who have the same goal. We are different, and that's where our strength lies. We will never be a monolithic, servile people. No leader will ever be able to build an authoritarian state here, because we are different, and it's a good thing. But we have to respect each other. For me, identification of my people is done using one simple question. Who does Crimea belong to? Every person will be my person if they respond to this question. Crimea is Ukraine.